I'm recording this as I am rendering my latest episode of the Intrepid podcast, and within that episode, I have told you about this very unfortunate incident that a student of a certain Catholic school smuggling the Blessed Sacrament for a so-called taste test. You know that I have very, very strong opinions regarding the Eucharist, regarding the Blessed Sacrament. As a Catholic, I should. But you see, there is this bitterness in my heart that I should have told you a while ago, because I've been doing this for the past few years and nobody listens, and here I am in the crossroads of vindicating myself, but I chose not to. I am choosing not to, because all of us are susceptible to this absolute sacrilege. And this is basically what I'm going to leave you for the rest of Lent.
In Spanish,
200 years. Hi, I'm Ian Riñon, an independent alternative media practitioner, among other things, and this is a very special recording for both the Intrepid Show and the Intrepid Podcast. This is a very special installment of my two programs here in IJR Productions for both YouTube and Spotify. So I am simultaneously releasing this for both my YouTube channel as well as Spotify, as I always do for my podcast episodes. Now, I am going to read to you the this year's Passiontide Address from yours truly, and I have already shared this via Facebook. I would link it in the description below so that you can read it. If you are interested in how I deliver the speech to you right now, maybe also check it out if you don't want to listen to me. You can read it on your own pace. Of course, you can do that. But let me go ahead and read to you my own perspective about what just happened this past few days, as well as what should I and we do about it. So I have entitled this Passiontide Address. Passiontide, by the way, is the last 2 weeks of Lent. It's basically Holy Week and the week before Holy Week. So that time is called Passiontide, and that's basically the time in the liturgical year that all images inside the church are covered. So that's basically what Passiontide is. And this is this year's Passiontide Address from yours truly. Over 10 years ago, I underwent a self-discovery in terms of how the Catholic faith should be embedded in Catholic institutions, especially where I studied. This was the result of a rather surprising internal conversion during my first few months in the university I attended. I have advocated for the incorporation and living out of the Catholic faith in my 4 years of stay, both in internal uni events and in the wider Philippine church. But because I was neither an illustrious student leader nor a diligent enough student, my recognitions and efforts were all but in vain. I have at least two colleagues from my own class that have represented our university in a game in some noontime variety show, which for some reason still exists as of this recording, and yet we're not given a simple shout out, not even given rather a simple shout out for their participation. How much more for someone who was part of promoting the sense of the sacred in all our institutional religious events, or at least tried to. It still pains me to this day that no one tried to understand my point. Perhaps more than I can admit. Yet, I have continued to trust in God that someday someone would realize that what I have been fighting for is something every single Catholic should consider giving a damn about. That day certainly came, but because of the woes of everyday life beyond school, it seems that I didn't notice it until we saw a series of incidents that put the church in a bad light. And most recently, the pain hits home and unfortunately comes full circle. As someone who is in a relationship with an alumna of the institution that housed a wayward student who may or may not have the slightest idea of what he has done to the most sacred body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus Christ in the form and accident of sanctified bread, I have the prerogative of telling people who have secretly or quietly or unintentionally shut me down for my perhaps uncontrolled zeal that I have warned them and they have not listened. However, my decade of lived experience makes me realize that that is not a Christian thing to do. Instead of going down the rabbit hole of feverish and unhealthy zeal, this is what I can say and this is what I can tell you right now. There must be a shift in our way of thinking about the Mass. As we enter into the most solemn of fortnights, the most solemn 2 weeks, if you don't know the term fortnight, in the liturgical year, let us remember that the Mass is not just a commemoration of the Last Supper, but also, and most importantly, the one true sacrifice of Christ on the cross renewed in every single altar in every single day. The altar becomes Calvary at every Mass, and methinks it is foolish to praise the Lord crucified for our sins through clapping and shouting and dancing. If we can shift into that mindset, perhaps there will be no liturgical abuses, no dumbing down of doctrine, and most especially, no sacrilege in receiving Holy Communion. And if I may add, the shift in mindset would encourage all of us to avoid receiving Holy Communion from our spiritually unworthy and physically and pathologically and biologically dirty hands. As much as we are supposed to be men and women for others, we must perhaps follow the order in which our Eucharistic Lord gives us His two greatest commandments. We must first love the Lord our God with all our heart, with all our soul, with all our mind, and with all our strength. Only then can we love our neighbor as we love ourselves. Thus, before we become men and women for others, let us be men and women for God first and foremost, lest we become discouraged by the utter obnoxiousness of the people we serve. And honestly, this is a very, very hard lesson you and I should learn. That, ladies and gentlemen, is my little address to all of you as we reflect on the Passion, Death, and Resurrection of Christ. as I mentioned in my previous recordings, either on YouTube or maybe on Spotify, I may not have announced it, but IGR Productions will scale down and will further scale down during Passiontide. So everything that is not really that important when it comes to pressing issues and all that would be deferred after Easter. Although there will also be one last episode of the Intrepid Show before Holy Week within Passiontide, and that's going to be on the 31st of March 2023. It will premiere March 31. That's going to be the last Friday of March at 8 p.m. Philippine Standard Time, 12 noon UTC, if I am not mistaken. So do check out for that. But other than that video for the Intrepid Show, the next few videos or the next recording for IGR Productions and for the Intrepid Ian Riñon channel on YouTube would be after Easter, so that I can lay low when it comes to doing this kind of stuff for our for YouTube, as well as so that I so that you can also go ahead and reflect on your own personal way on how to remember what happened 2,000 years ago. So, with all that said, this is Intrepid Ian Riñon reminding you to, at all times, now more than ever, in these last 2 weeks of Lent, be the salt of the earth and the light of the world. Until then, look alive, stay alive, be kind to yourself and to each other, pray, fast, give alms, and pray some more. And as always, thank you for watching. From here in Intrepid HQ, see you in Easter. Ian out.